guys, today I have with me the InstaX Mini 9 by Fujifilm. This camera comes with 5 different color options. I have the Flamingo Pink one with me. Now, in this video, I will be unboxing and giving you a quick review of this Polaroid camera. Let's get started.
So, this is what the box looks like. Now, let's quickly unbox this and see what all we get inside it. I've emptied the box now and this is all we get. So the first thing we have is this close-up lens attachment. You need to attach this on the lens of the camera to get better shots and selfies. This is a side strap. You need to attach this on the side of the camera to get a better grip of the camera. Then we have the camera itself. We'll be talking about this later. Then we have a warranty card, some instruction manuals and a couple of stickers. So this is what the camera looks like. It's quite sturdy and fits really well in your hand. When we look at the front of the camera, we have the flash, viewfinder, shutter button, selfie mirror, lens, and next to the lens we have this button from where the camera will start. When we look at the top of the camera, we have the slot from where the developed photos will come out of. At the back we have this compartment where you need to insert the films. I've already inserted one. And from here you can keep a count of how many shots are left in the film. Here you need to keep put the batteries, the AA batteries, and this is for the strap. So that's pretty much it. As we take a closer look on the dial of the camera, we can see a series of LED lights over here. These lights indicate what shooting mode you're in. This is indicated by the light indicator over here. Right now it's pointing at indoors, so we need to keep the dial over here, but you can adjust it accordingly. If you want clearer pictures, you can keep it on high key, but right now as it's saying I should put it on indoor, I'll leave it over here. Now let's take some pictures and see how these pictures turn out.
So I will be taking few pictures, one with the close-up lens attachment and one without it, so that we can compare the difference. Also, one thing you need to keep in mind while taking selfies is that you need to look at the selfie mirror, not the viewfinder, so that the frame of the picture is fine.
So these are the two pictures. They took about a minute to develop. They are about the size of a credit card, and there's a little space at the bottom of the picture where you can write the date or a message. So when we take a closer look at these pictures, I personally don't find much difference between them. This one was taken with the close-up lens attachment and the other one was taken without it.
In all, I think this is a great camera to capture snapshots and collect memories in the form of pictures. Thank you for watching.